Alan talked to me about his mother. He knew why she died. She couldn't live up to your expectations either, and that's why she killed herself.
She did not kill herself. It was an accident.
No, Mr. Jeffries, it was not.
You get out. You hear me? Get out!
Can't see anyone taking me on with a record. Tom was smart enough to work that out, too. Bastard even threatened me if I said anything.
What a maggot after all you've done for him!
Do I have to stand here waiting for you two all night? Come on, it's time for lock-up.
Just going, Mrs. Pale.
How long were you standing there?
Too long. Get your things and get back to your cell.
What did you overhear?
Get out.
Trouble is, the bitch is right. If she does wake up dead in the morning, they're gonna lock us up and throw away the key.
You mean we're right back where we started?
Looks like it, doesn't it?
Good night, girls.
All right, ladies, everyone who's ready can move off to breakfast.
At least we're getting decent tucker with Lizzie in the kitchen.
Yeah, as long as they lock away the rat poison.
Oh, it gets up my nose the way she stuffed things up.
Yeah, typical.
Still reckon she's the lagger.
I'm bloody sure of it, but proving it's another thing. Still, she didn't get off scot-free. She's got to live with it.
Oh, are you going soft in the head or something? Do you reckon she gives a damn?
Yeah, I do. She didn't mean to torch anybody any more than we did. That part of it was an accident.
We're still the poor buggers who are copping murder and arson charges.
Well, let's just hope that Judy gets us a top-notch lawyer. I don't think anyone should do extra time for an accident. And I'm going to make damn sure we don't.
Hey! Bill! You seen Po-Face this morning?
Oh, no. Look, I didn't sleep a wink last night. I was so worried.
Yeah, I would be too.
Maybe she won't say anything.
You're joking, aren't you? She's a screw, isn't she? Anything she can get on you, she'll use it.
Come on. So it's confirmed, tomorrow? Yes, all right, Mrs. Davidson. Thank you.
Well, you look like you've got the weight of the world on your shoulders.
No, but at least some of it has been lifted. We're going back to Wentworth tomorrow, all being well.
That'd make you happy.
Mm.
And the rest of the burden?
Just being a prison officer.
You need a hand?
No, not really. Well, I happened to overhear one of the women talking. And it was the sort of talk that could get her a lot of extra time.
And you don't know whether you should keep it to yourself or not?
Hmm.
Was it about the fire?
Oh, God, no. Anything to do with that, and I'd be straight into the governor's office. Still, I wasn't meant to hear.
Sometimes it's better to be deaf, dumb, and blind.
And I know it.
But on the other hand, we do have a job to do, and anything important should be passed on.
Right.
Without letting our personal feelings get in the way.
I will sort it out.
Let's talk about it over lunch, eh?
Mm-hmm.
See you later.
Okay.
Seems to be showing a more than professional interest.
No, I don't think so. It's just work and we're going to have lunch together. A few things I want to talk to him about.
Yes, of course.
Big crook around here, isn't it?
No kidding.
You know what this mob needs is a chin wag with Lizzie. She'd seem to get him jumping up and down.
What do you mean?
Oh, just do cooking, you know. She might put a few magic mushrooms in the stew or something.
Smith, you've got a visitor.
Is it from the legal service?
That's right.
You beauty. Jude must have done nice stuff.
Yeah, good luck.
I wish we didn't have to go through all this again.
again.
Yes, well, you have to. Just relax. It'll be all right.
I know they're going to say I killed him.
Sarah, will you stop it? You're not to blame for Alan's death. There's nothing to be frightened of.
Not when Mr. Jeffries has got somebody like him.
Answer their questions and relax. It's going to be okay, huh?
All rise. Coroner's Court is now in session. This is an inquiry into the death of Alan Jeffries.
So that's the way it stands. The cops conned me into admitting I'd assaulted the screw.
And Miss Latham started the fire as a diversionary tactic.
Yeah, that's right. How come you don't know all this?
Oh, you're the first person I've talked with.
Oh, so now you're here. What can you do?
Well, let's start with the assault charge. I take it there was some provocation?
Sure, she's a sadistic bitch and she had it coming.
We might be able to use that.
Forget it. I can't prove it, and frightened women don't make good witnesses.
All right, what about the other charge?
Not guilty. Oh, look, I know it's going to be hard to prove, but I do know something that might be of some help.
Yes?
The cops let it slip that it wasn't the little bonfire in the library that caused all the damage.
What was it then?
Someone threw a Molotov cocktail in a completely different place.
Who?
Well, I know it wasn't Chrissie or me.
Or name?
No. Sorry.
Come on, Mrs. Smith. It could mean the difference between you being convicted or not.
All that matters is the cops can't prove it was us.
They can build up a pretty good case from the rest of the evidence.
That's not proof, it's circumstantial.
I'd like that name.
No. I am not interested in setting anybody else up. I'm only interested in getting us off the hook.
I think you're underestimating your position. You're facing very serious charges.
Yes, I had realized that.
Well, then I'd advise you to cooperate with me completely. Ugh. Otherwise, I mightn't be able to help you at all.
You will tell the court of the events on the afternoon in question.
After I'd been to court, I rang Alan, asked him to come round.
Which he did?
Yes.
What happened after that?
His father arrived. He was pretty angry with Alan for being there, wanted him to go home.
Not to see you again?
Alan refused. There was a terrible row. His father started telling him how hopeless he was, that I'd dragged him down. Just kept yelling. We knew he'd never leave us alone.
Objection, Your Worship. Miss Hamilton is giving an opinion, not fact.
Sustained. Keep to the facts, please.
Go on.
We went up to my room after Mr. Jeffries left. We talked. We decided there was nothing left for either of us.
But I understand only you were being charged with the drug offence.
Alan had other problems.
What did you decide to do?
I just wanted to finish it altogether.
That's a pretty big decision to make. Had you discussed it before?
No.
I'm wondering what put that particular solution into the young man's head.
I told you. There was nothing left. We both just wanted to die.
Knowing one way or the other than worrying about it.
But I might just make things worse if I say anything. Maybe she's going to forget the whole thing.
Bullshit.
Well, then why doesn't she say something to me?
It's called slow torture. She gets your hopes up, and then when you think you're okay, she fixes your little red quacker good and proper.
Not enough work to do, ladies.
Yes, plenty, thanks, Mrs. Powell.
Then cut the chat and get on with it.
You reckon you can trust that bitch? You got Buckley's.
Miss Hamilton, The drugs which resulted in the death of Alan Jeffries, where did they come from?
I don't know.
Oh. They were just sitting in a drawer. Someone planted them there, I suppose.
Alan brought them with him.
I thought you were the one facing drug charges.
Yes.
Then I suggest that you were the one who produced the drugs that evening.
No, I've told you it...
On your own admittance, Mr. Jeffries came to see you to warn his son about you.
That's got nothing to do with...
He thought you shouldn't see each other because Alan was going to testify against you in court. Is that correct?
Yes, but he was doing
it... I further suggest Mr. Jeffries was worried about what you might do if left alone with his son.
That's ridiculous.
Do you deny the deceased was going to testify against you?
No, but it was his father's idea. At first, we were both going to be charged. He has a great deal of money and influence which he used to get Alan off. Testifying against me was Mr. Jeffries' idea.
Just a moment, Miss Hamilton. That's a very serious accusation.
I know that.
Have you any proof that Mr. Jeffries bought his son's freedom? Well?
No, but I'm quite sure.
That's not good enough. Please think carefully before you give the court your answers in future.
Yes, Your Worship.
Now, you claim that Alan Jeffries loved you.
He did, very much.
Strange, a man who loved you should want to speak against you in court.
He was weak and frightened. His father pushed and pushed him.
I maintain Alan Jeffries was indeed frightened of your unhealthy influence over him.
That's not true.
And that you would rather see him dead than as witness against you.
That's not true. He knows it's not true.
Sit down. You're acting for B. Smith in this Wentworth business, I believe.
Trying to.
Yes, I know what you mean. I've been going through the statements from the women prisoners. This case isn't as straightforward as I thought it was.
Right. I was hoping you could fill me in on a few details.
Shouldn't you be asking your client to do that for you?
My client isn't being particularly cooperative.
I can't say I blame her. She's a veteran. She knows there's not much point in bucking the system.
You think someone's having her?
No, I wouldn't say that. Let's just say that the department and the officers are rather anxious to pin the rap on somebody.
Smith did mention a third person. No, someone else who started the big fire.
Name?
Wouldn't say. But if you could help me piece one or two things together, maybe I can help you too.
Oh, I can't do that. This is all private, confidential.
Ah.
I'm sorry. Still, a cup of coffee might cheer you up. How do you take it?
Black with wine, thanks.
You can entertain yourself for a while, can you? That kettle takes a devil of a time to boil.
To get away from it all.
Mm.
Lunch and Woodridge don't mix.
Well, I still haven't decided what to do about that woman.
The one whose conversation you overheard.
Yeah. God, I hate this kind of decision.
Like I said, it's nice to get away from the problems of work.
Isn't that why we're here? Talk about them?
What do you think? The way I see it, the women are angry because of the overcrowded conditions, and the men are angry because they've lost some of their facilities.
Right.
But you'll all be going back to Wentworth tomorrow, so that'll take care of that, won't it?
Not everything's that simple.
Don't I know it? I'll be sorry to see you go. I'd like to keep in touch.
That might be a bit difficult.
Why?
Well, it's been very pleasant and I've enjoyed your company. But there's no reason to see each other once we go back.
Does there have to be a reason?
I'm married. makes it a bit awkward.
I'm married too, but I'd still like to see you. Does your husband go away much?
Now and then. Seems to have been away forever this time.
How about dinner tomorrow night, anywhere you like?
I think I'd better just get through lunch.
I couldn't eat anything.
Sarah, what the hell were you doing in there? Judy, why didn't you tell them about Mrs. Jeffries' suicide?
I couldn't talk about her like that. Ellen loved it too much.
It would have made a hell of a difference. For God's sake, Sarah, this is an inquest. They want to know the truth in there. And there's nothing that you can say about Alan or his mother that's going to hurt them now.
I couldn't.
Well, I suppose you're proud of yourself, aren't you? You're going to stuff up another life, are you?
I've got nothing to say to you.
Yeah, well, I've got plenty to say to you. You hounded your wife and your son until they killed themselves. And now you're going to try and kill Sarah.
That's enough.
Oh, no, it's not. He's going to hear me out. You know what he did? His wife, she committed suicide because she couldn't live up to the standard that the bastard set for her.
Shut your filthy mouth.
And then that worried your son so much that eventually he couldn't stand it either.
Miss Bryant.
Sarah, she could have got up in court. She could have told them all of that, but she didn't. And you know why? Because she didn't want to drag your wife's name through the mud.
Stop it.
Now, that kid there, she could end up on a manslaughter charge. She loved your son. But no, you had to push and push him until he couldn't take it anymore, the same way you pushed your wife.
Shut up!
And I got one more thing to say to you. If this barrister, if he gives Sarah a hard time in that court, then I'm going to get up and I'm going to tell them everything I know.
There's no need to threaten me, Miss Bryant. I've already made up my mind what to do about this situation, with or without your interference.
Mr. Jeffries, I know this isn't pleasant for you, but please tell the court the emotional state your son was in that last afternoon.
He was very upset.
Why was that?
Alan had a great deal of difficulty accepting his mother's death.
Your worship.
It's all right. I know what I'm saying. In fact, Alan was very depressed. You see, his mother died only a couple of years ago, quite suddenly. It was a terrible shock to both of us.
I see.
Alan was never the same after that.
Do you believe this caused the depression which led to his suicide?
I think he blamed himself. Felt he'd caused it through his own failures. But it wasn't his fault. It was mine. I suppose I did push too hard. But it's just that I loved them both so much. I just wanted the best for them. Now I've lost them both. And I never even told them how much I cared.
As a result of the inquiry into the death of Alan Jeffries, I record a finding of death by misadventure due to a drug overdose administered by the deceased's own hand. I also find that there is no reason to lay charges against any person or persons.
Well, I feel much better after that. Thank you.
Good. Maybe it'll help you decide about that dinner date.
Think about it.
I'm a very patient man.
Oh, have a nice lunch?
Yes, lovely, thank you.
Any disasters?
No, all under control. Oh, Colleen, Valerie Jacobs' release sheet just came through.
Oh, I see.
Well, perhaps you'd like to tell her. She'll be leaving us tomorrow.
I'm so glad to get out of there. I really thought it was going to go against me.
I told you it was going to be all right, didn't I?
Well, goodbye, Mr. Jeffries. Good to meet you.
Thank you. Goodbye.
Mr. Jeffries, I just wanted to tell you I'm sorry.
We won't have to meet again. I can't say I'm sorry about that.
Come on, honey, let's go home, huh?
Miss Hamilton. I'm Detective Gilbert.
What do you want?
Just a word about the charges against you.
Well, you heard the coroner's findings. I mean, surely there can't be a manslaughter charge.
Naturally, that's been dropped. We'd have decided not to go on with the drug charges either, seeing that Ellen Jeffries was our chief witness against you. I'm sure I don't have to remind you that any future association with drugs would be extremely unwise.
Certainly don't. Judy, I got the lid. Yes, can I help you?
Jerry Steele. Can I see B. Smith, please? I'm a solicitor.
Well, I don't think that should be too difficult. If you'd just like to sign in there.
Thank you. Conditions are pretty cramped around here, I suppose.
Yes, they are.
I'm told the fire at Wentworth made a bit of a mess.
To say nothing of the loss of life.
Terrible. There'd be more than a few people wanting to see the firebug caught, I should think.
Yes.
I don't suppose you could tell me who left the turps lying around in an electrical storeroom.
Beg your pardon?
Oh, I know all about it. Part of my job to dig around, find things out. Well?
If you wish to discuss the fire, I suggest you talk to our deputy governor.
Thought you might be able to help me, that's all.
If you're ready, Mr. Steele.
You know what I reckon? We should have broken the rules and had a bottle of champagne.
Coffee's fine.
Well, it was quite a day, wasn't it?
Mm. They really had me worried right up to the last minute.
Yeah. It's all over now, though, love. And what are your plans?
Back to uni.
Now, that is a good idea. We'll be able to use all the free legal aid we can get.
That's a deal.
Good on you.
Thanks, Judy.
How did the homework go?
Well, but from now on, it's going to take teamwork. If we're going to get any further, then I'll need answers.
Well, like I said before, just as long as you don't expect me to lag.
No. No need for that now. I'm more interested in one of the women who died in the fire. A Miss Fields.
Barbara? What about her?
They found her in the governor's office. You got any idea why she'd be in there?
Yeah, I think so. She had something on one of the screws. Ferguson, the one I attacked.
Did she? What sort of thing?
Diaries written by Ferguson herself. Pretty damning stuff, or so Barbara reckoned. Poor bitch was probably trying to stop them going up in smoke when she copped it.
Good. I've been looking for something like that.
Well, how's that going to help me?
All part of the plan.
You're not going to blame the fire on Barbara.
No, nothing like that. I'm not particularly interested in the person who started the big one anymore.
Why not? I thought that was the basis
of our... Because I'm changing direction. Ever wonder why the fire spread so far, so quickly?
Well, there was a bloody Molotov cocktail, wasn't there?
It was more than that. It was thrown in a storeroom, and the storeroom had several cartons of turp sitting there.
Bloody hell.
Now, one of the officers must have authorised them to be there.
And the screws are more to blame than anyone.
Partly to blame, anyway.
Those women die because of some careless bloody screw. Bastards! Well, no wonder they're so anxious to pin it on Chrissie and me.
Right.
Well, you've got to get word out to the papers and...
Hang on. You can't go off half-cocked.
Our necks are on the line.
I haven't exactly got a signed confession, you know.
Well, what do you expect us to do? Sit around and forget about it?
Of course not. I think I've come up with a better way of exposing this.
Job hunting going? You find anything?
Nah, same bloody stuff. All them factory jobs. And you find 30 people waiting in line when you get there.
Yeah, it's tough, isn't it?
Gotta get something soon, but go through the dole like a dose of salts.
You can say that again. Well, at least you can stay here for a while if you behave yourself.
I suppose so. Couldn't advance me a few bucks, could you? Just till my next check comes.
I'm sorry, Hazel.
Well, I thought you had dough for emergencies and stuff.
Yes, emergencies, maybe, but you know what happened the last time I gave you some money?
It was different. I was feeling real butchers. I needed the grog to pick
all right,
me up.
All right. Hello, Driscoll House, Judy Bryant speaking. Oh, yeah, I'll get her.
Jean, phone.
Right.
Look, honey, I know you've had a really bad time, but that's over now. You can start all over again, afresh. I mean, if you stay on the booze, well, you're not going to get anywhere. Think of your kids.
That's all I ever think about.
Good. Because if you stay on the booze, you will never see them again.
I'm not a bloody alcoholic. Just got a few hassles at the moment, that's all.
That was the abattoirs. I've got an interview.
Well, that's terrific.
Well, it's not much of a job, I suppose, but it's a start.
Yeah.
I better go and spruce myself up.
You see? Okay, so maybe you get a lousy job, but it's better than nothing.
Hey, this doesn't taste too bad at all, Lizzie. I reckon you're to take over from Mrs. O'Regan when we get back.
Ah, can't muck up a stew.
My chook would have looked better sitting on this plate.
Hey, Lizzie, how's the booth coming along?
Shh, keep it down. Don't want the whole mob in on it.
Well, you got any yet?
No. Those blokes are real mean buggers. They want the top dollar. I've got an idea, though, how I can get some.
Yeah, well, there hasn't been much floating around since the fire and since that bloody raffle.
Yeah, and I know they won't give me any. That's why I need you.
Yeah? What for?
Help me put on a game of poker.
Oh, ripper! Nobody's got no cards but...
except me.
Where did you get them?
I used some of the dough from the raffle and bought them from the blokes. And they're real ace cards, if you know what I mean. Seeing I stuffed you all up over the raffle, I thought I'd pay you all back with these.
Hey!
Took all my spare cash and my best smile to get Charlie to part with them.
Good one, Lizzie.
Well, how about starting straight away? What about a game of poker, girl?
Yeah. Hey, what are we supposed to play with? I'm just about broke.
Oh, well, we could make the stakes pretty low. At least some lucky bugger would pick up something.
Now, it sounds okay to me. Won't you girls go ahead? I've got some thinking to do.
Yeah, I reckon I'll dip out too, because I spend all my dough on the chook and the cards, and I'd hate to take your money if I won.
Well, who's going to deal then? We've got to have someone we can trust.
Well, I don't mind doing that, seeing that I won't be playing.
Yeah, well, at least if it's not a player, we know there's no funny business.
Right. Here we go.
Well, it looks like we're in for a beaut evening after all.
Hurry up, Lizzie.
Oh.
That's mine.
All right.
Oh. That's the last time I play cards with you, Maxine.
Yeah, bit of a fluke, wasn't it?
Yeah, wasn't it?
Sometimes it happens like that. You're on a winning streak and you stay with it.
Sometimes it happens you cheat.
Hey! I play clean like I always do. At least in my games, people only lose their money, not their lives.
I'm sorry you said
yeah.
that.
Yeah,
I'm getting it out of you, Judy. Will you shut up?
What's going on?
It's this place, Mrs. M. We're always tripping all over each other.
Yes, I realise that.
Well, everyone's getting jumpy. You got any idea when we're going to get out of here?
Yes, it's been confirmed.
Well, don't keep us in suspense.
You're leaving Woodridge this afternoon.
Oh, heavens for that.
In the meantime, you've just got to try and manage. Now, everyone who's ready, off to the showers, please.
Okay, you bitch.
I said stop it!
Now, listen, you lot. I know what Margo did was bloody stupid, but something has come up which means it was not entirely her fault.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
I can't tell you at the moment. But you'll find out sooner or later. Let's just can the wisecracks, eh? Get out.
I wish you'd bloody tell me what's going on. I don't know where I am, all this blowing hot and cold.
Won't be long now.
Oh, give me the dough. I've got to hurry up and get the grog.
Hey, Lizzie, I've got to hand it to you. When it comes to stack cards, you come up. Come on.
Oh, come on, lazy bones. There's a brand new day out there.
So what?
So you got to get up bright and early if you want to get a look in at the best jobs.
What's the bloody point?
You
Same old story. Nobody wants to know you.
You gotta give it a try.
Well, what are you so chirpy about? You didn't get that one you went for yesterday, did you?
No. But it doesn't mean I'm not going to hit the jackpot today, though.
Best of luck, then.
Look, there's no point in giving up. The world's still going on out there. You've got to face it sooner or later. May as well be today.
You're starting to sound like Jude.
I'm only trying to help.
Yeah? How about lending me some cash, then?
Well, I would if I could. But why do you think I'm so dead set on getting a job? I haven't got a brass razoo to my name.
Well, that makes bloody two of us.
Jacobs.
Yes, Miss Powell?
Come with me. You're being processed out.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Hey, I bet you never had a nicer order. Good luck, love.
Come on, I haven't got all day.
Oh, gee. Been nice knowing you, Val.
Yeah, it's not often we get to hear real hot stories about our mates.
Coming. Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Thank you. You know, I can't see how those two could ever have been mates.
Colleen, Mrs. Powell.
Yes?
I want to thank you. I mean, you must have overheard Maxine and me talking about Tom and the shop.
I'd rather not discuss it.
But I can't just leave without saying anything. I mean, you could have made things very hard for me.
True.
I was sure you'd put your job first, dob me in. I guess our friendship must have meant something after all.
No. No, don't flatter yourself. Just try and stay out of trouble in the future.
Oh, I will. I've made a lot of mistakes in my life, haven't I? Funny, isn't it? I used to think I was happy, but what have I got to show for it? A conviction and a guy who dumped me. Lucky you. You've got two kids and a husband who loves you very much. It must be good to feel secure.
Going?
Fine. I've just been clearing Valerie Jacobs for release. She's gone now, and for good, I hope.
She's the one who's been troubling you, isn't she?
Yes. And as you've probably gathered, I made my decision. We were friends once, and you can't forget old friendships, no matter what the circumstances are.
No.
They might be over, but, oh, I don't know. Still memories, obligations.
What about new friendships? Is our dinner date still on?
I'm sorry, Jeff, I can't.
Well, I'll settle for another lunch then.
No lunch, no dinner. I might have saved Valerie some time, but compared to me, she really doesn't have much. She's got nobody, and I have a family. I wouldn't want to hurt them.
I'm sorry.
So am I. Still, they're very important to me.
Patrick's a lucky man. I hope he realizes what he's got.
I think he's happy.
Promise me one thing, will you?
What's that?
If you ever change your mind, let me be the first to know.
Charlie come up with the goods yet?
Did he ever? I got enough booze for both of us this whole afternoon.
You little beauty. Hey, where is it?
Stuck it up in your jumper.
We can't very well take a swig in here, because even if the screws don't cotton on, the others will.
Yeah. Well, I've been thinking about that, and I reckon we've been in this hole long enough. A bit of fresh air's in order.
Come on, Lizzie.
Well, what's the matter, Lizzie? Are you all right?
I just feel a bit dicey, Mrs. M. I think my ticket might be playing up a bit.
Do you want to report sick?
No. Just like to get in the fresh air, see a bit of sunlight. Think it'd be all right if Maxie and me had our tucker in the yard.
Oh, I don't see why not. But you'd better tell Mrs. Barfield I gave you permission.
Oh, Beardy. I reckon only a few minutes would do the trick.
Hey, those two are up to something. You got any idea what it is?
Lizzie, how about a quick snort now? There's no one around.
Yeah, okay. Oh, mightn't be as good as the Birdsworth brew, but it'll do me.
Well, thank guts at all. I want some too, remember?
Don't worry, I've got plenty of us stashed away. I've got bottles everywhere, enough for a good long party.
Well, how are we going to get it back to Wentworth?
Yeah, we'll have to think about that. You watch out for some empty shampoo bottles for starters.
Maybe you won't have enough to take back to Wentworth with you.
You've got no right to sneak up on people like that.
Yeah, and you've got no right to hold out on this booze supply from your mates.
You're no mate of mine, Gaffney.
No, but let's just see how the others take to being kept in the dark, eh?
Bloody hell. Now all the others will want to be in for that chop.
Yes, very well. We'll expect you later then.
Right.
They are sending a bus over later this afternoon to pick up the women.
Well, I won't be sorry.
No, this place has been getting us all down.
No regrets about going?
Well, I could have made a bit of a fool of myself over Jeff, but I didn't. All we had was a very pleasant lunch together.
I was worried there for a while.
So was I. Case of the old ego, I suppose. Now, come on, when you've been married for 17 years, it's very flattering to know that somebody notices you.
Case of the grass being greener on the other side.
Never is it?
Oh, did B's lawyer get in touch with you?
No, why?
Well, he made some remark about the Terps being in the electrical storeroom.
Well, how did he find out about that?
I have no idea. I mean, he doesn't know who was responsible.
Damn it.
Well, I suggested he direct any inquiries to you. Not that I expected you to say anything.
No, not likely. God, if that gets out, I'm in real trouble.
So what's all this about a grog supply?
Well, I was gonna tell everyone. We was just having a quick squeak to see if it was okay. Oh, come on, pull the other one.
Yeah.
Honest, if I'd bragged about it, the screws might have twigged. It was meant to be a surprise.
We've had quite enough surprises, thank you. Margo reckons you've got enough to get an army rotten.
We've only got a few bottles.
That'll do. I reckon we all deserve a party after being cooped up in this joint. What do you say, girl?
Yeah!
And you're just the one to organise the grog.
Fair go, B.
Now.
Well, I'll have to have cash out front because those blokes don't just hand it out.
That's okay. We'll toss in a bit.
Where from? I've lost all my dough on the poker and the raffle.
And that's exactly why Lizzie and Maxine are going to put in most of it.
Oh, you gotta be joking.
And in return, we'll forget that little run of luck in the poker game.
Bloody lovely. When an old lag like me can't even have a drop to drink without all this aggro.
Thank you.
job interviews?
No, you know how it is. They all want your life history and the kind of references that make you sound like little Miss Goody Two-Shoes.
Well, don't let it get you down, love. Something will turn up sooner or later.
Oh, I suppose so. I'm buggered. Fancy a cup of tea?
Yeah, you're on. What's up?
Just got together some of my gear. Thought I might get a few bucks for it at the pawn shop.
Oh, good idea, but don't you let those bastards rip you off.
I won't.
And don't go blowing it all on booze, neither.
Mr. Douglas, we weren't expecting you.
Get me Smith and Latham, Mrs. Powell.
Do you want to see them in the visiting room?
I want to see them here and now.
Right, Maxie, door.
Hey!
Get.
Oh, bloody hell, B!
Come on, Lizzie. And over.
Oh, I was so busy I forgot all about the booze.
Come on, you old bugger, where is it?
Oh, I slipped it under here when the screws weren't watching. I nearly got caught more than once, so there you go.
Hey, that's not bad, not bad at all.
Where's the rest of it?
Woo-hoo, them blokes aren't only good for one thing after all.
Screws!
Smith and Latham, you're wanted in reception.
What for?
Get to reception, you'll find out.
Ladies, don't do too much of anything we'd enjoy, will you?
Hey!
Oh, I wish B wouldn't keep things from her mates. Oh, bloody hell. Oh, that bitch.
Thieving little bitch!
What the hell's going on?
It's Hazel. She's nicked me cash.
I thought you said you didn't have any money.
Well, I did. What I put away for a rainy day and it's gone, the whole damn lot.
Well, maybe if you'd been honest with me...
Don't you start lecturing me. That lousy bitch has stolen it.
Are you sure you haven't misplaced it?
What? You saw her with the suitcase. She wasn't going to a pawn shop. She was clearing out. When I find her, she'll wish she hadn't been born.
You going to call the cops?
No cops. I don't want any cops.
How much money was it?
Oh, forget it. I'll take care of this myself, all right?
Oh, and there, God, I reckon I'll ask Charlie for the recipe.
Yeah, the more you drink, the better it gets.
Yeah, I bet Ben and Chrissie are pissed off missing out on this one, eh?
Yeah, I wonder what old Po-Face wanted with them.
Well, I just hope he knows what she's doing.
Mrs. Morris.
I know it's hard on you all, locked up here with nothing to
do. Yeah, enough to drive you to drink.
But it's nearly over. You can pack your belongings. You'll be leaving for Wentworth in half an hour.
Will Ben and Chrissie be coming with us, Mrs. F?
Of course. Why would we want to leave them locked up in a men's prison? Now, hurry it up. The bus will be here and I'd want you all to be ready.
We're not going to leave all this booze behind, are we?
No way. I've worked that one out. Empty your hot water bottles, girls, because you won't be warming your feet with them tonight.
Due to various questions being raised, Mr. Steele thinks that an informal discussion on the fire is in order.
I don't think my client should have been charged with arson and murder.
The police have statements.
And I have a couple of interesting facts. The fire spread so rapidly because it came in contact with turps, which was left in an electrical storeroom. Quite against regulations,
that
I believe.
That has nothing to do with it. If one of the women hadn't thrown that Molotov cocktail, the whole thing wouldn't have happened.
Oh, I agree. But it is against regulations, you must admit. Now, as Deputy Governor, was it your decision to have it stored there?
Well, it wasn't...
I won't have my officers cross-examined like this.
Whatever you say. But what we have, you must agree, is purely circumstantial evidence against my clients.
Well, in fairness to Mr. Douglas, you must remember that Smith admitted to assaulting an officer and Latham lit a fire as a diversion.
I was just coming to that. Tell us about that part of it. How on earth did you get Officer Ferguson to isolation?
She was after her diaries.
Which you said were in isolation?
Yeah, that's right. She was desperate to get them back. Barbara had stolen them. Apparently they made very interesting reading. All about bribery and corruption.
For heaven's sake, the woman's obviously telling a pack of lies.
Really? And where had Miss Fields actually hidden the diaries?
In the governor's office. She was probably trying to get them back.
Can you produce these diaries?
Well, of course not. They've been burnt, along with Barbara.
Well, then I don't see how...
Any other reason why Fields would have been found in the governor's office when she died?
Well, no, but I...
There are a lot of buts in this case, Mr. Douglas, and a lot of issues that I intend to raise if my clients are charged.
Are you attempting to blackmail the department?
Only see that justice is done. Let's face it. If all this is made public, nobody is going to look good. So I suggest we come to some sort of agreement, for everyone's sake.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed.